Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I hope you are doing absolutely fine. So today we are going to talk about how you can select solar panel for your particular project. So before starting with today's video, those who are new to the channel, make sure you subscribe to our channel. Here basically we talk about all the concepts related to electrical engineering as well as solar. Guys, if you want me to make a video on how the technology in solar panel has developed or advanced from last few years, from normal solar panel to present HIT type of modules. If you want me to make a video on that particular topic, then do let me know in the comments. So let's start with today's video. There are certain factors which you need to consider for selection of solar panels for a particular project. First is the solar capacity which you need to be installed. The step of selection of solar panels comes after the calculation of the solar capacity. Okay, so by doing your electricity bill analysis for a particular facility, you come up with a particular solar capacity which you need to install. So first thing what you need to do is you need to know the shadow free area available for installation of solar at the particular site. Then you need to compare that is the space is enough for installation or it is less. Okay, so depending upon that, what you do, suppose the area available is large, okay, and it is very much sufficient for your solar to install, then simply you can choose normal panels with 330, 350 watt peak panels. Okay, it is not required that you specifically go for half cut cell or mono or something like PRC technology. Okay, because these panels are costly as compared to the normal panel. Yes, they slightly perform better than the normal panels, but the price of these panels is high. Suppose that you want to install more solar capacity in the particular available area. So what you do at this time, first thing is you increase the capacity of the panel. Okay, you choose a panel which is with more power output, maybe you can say 400 watt peak or 450 watt peak. Okay, and the next thing you can do is basically you can reduce the pitch, okay, between the two rows of your installation. As you can see on your screen, basically these are the two rows, okay, and this is the solar panel. So end of this panel to end of this panel, this distance is called as pitch. So what you basically do to accommodate more modules in particular area, you reduce this distance. So because of this, what happens, there is a shadow on the lower side of the panel in the early morning as well as late evening time. Okay, but still that is not a problem, as in morning as well as in evening the generation is less because the radiation is not that strong. So this totally accounts for almost 25% of the solar generation as compared to the peak hours. Suppose you want to reduce the inter-row spacing, as you can see on your screen, in early morning and evening, late evening, there is a inter-row shadow on the lower part of the panels. So because of which the generation is adversely affected. If you use normal full cell panel, then the whole panel will lose the generation. Okay, but whereas if you use half cut cell panel, as you can see on your screen, it will perform 50% better. So this is how you select panels as compared to your space constraint. So before concluding this point, I would like to tell you that whenever there is space constraint, either you go for high capacity modules, and second is you can reduce the pitch, okay, and you have to use the half cut cell panel. Okay, this is first thing. And second, suppose there is an area, suppose you are installing for your residential area, then what is happening, suppose because of external factors there is shadow casting on the panels, so because of shadow again your performance will get affected. So in such situations also consider the half cut cell panels. The next important point is price for the panels. So friends, here I would like to tell you that module cost or the solar panel cost accounts almost 55 to 60% of the total project cost. So it's a very big factor for the costing of the project. So you need to choose your panels very wisely, because every project is basically investment of money, and you want that money to return back as soon as possible in a short payback period. So you can consider the market prices for different modules, and according to that you can do the selection. This was the second point. And third is the efficiency of the module. As you all know, if you use monocrystalline module, it will perform slightly better than the polycrystalline panel. The difference is almost 1% or 1.5%. So that you can see on the next part of the video. The next point you need to consider is performance at different temperature. This basically is an important factor which need to be considered if you are going to install your plant in an area where the climate is very hot. Suppose we'll consider Middle East, or even in our areas in India also, if you consider high temperature areas. So at that particular area, you need to consider the coefficient of power with respect to temperature, that I will explain you in detail in later part of the video. So guys, on your screen you can see a table in which I have listed all the different types of panels on your screen, and I have also mentioned their efficiencies as well as their tentative prices as per the Indian market. And here I have considered the power loss, like coefficient of power loss, okay, with respect to temperature. There might be some error in the rates, but what I have received from all the suppliers I have listed accordingly, okay. So as you can see here, that normal poly and mono panel is almost, the price difference is 2 rupees, so you can take the call as per your particular application. But mostly if you want to consider half cut cell, okay, or PERC, you can also do that as per the pricing here, and their efficiencies are also mentioned. So talking about HIT, that is heterojunction technology module, okay, so you can see here the efficiency is 22%, and this technology is basically is almost around 1.5 years now in the market, and it is advancing more and more. So in upcoming time the efficiency will also go high. But as you can see here, the price of this particular module is 36 rupees, okay. I mean, you can see, consider that it is almost double to that of normal panels. So the payback period for such a project will be very high. So generally we do not propose this solution to normal clients. Suppose there is a big brand who want to install, they have a special requirement that they want such high performance module only, then only we propose such solutions. I advise you the same. So moreover, you can go for mono or poly, full cell or half cell, or with the PERC, depending upon which is more financially feasible for you guys. Okay guys, so now I consider that now you have calculated, or now you are aware that which capacity of the module you want to select. We'll consider 350 watt peak. So I have considered two companies here. On my left is one company, on my right is the other company. So do not consider the name of the companies. I do not want to defame any company. So because they all have different models, and their new models will be like performing better than the other. So we are just referring it for an example, that how you can select the panels by like comparing the two companies. So first part you need to consider is the module efficiency. As you can see here, for 350 watt peak module the efficiency is 19.52, whereas for this is 17.9. The detail was on other part of the data sheet, and I was not able to capture it in one image, that's why I have manually written it here, okay. But still you can see that in comparison this particular module is more efficient than the other one, okay. This is one major factor. The next major factor is this is the temperature coefficient of power. For every rise in temperature there will be 0.35% decrease in the power, whereas here it is 0.39%. But here it's not mentioned in Celsius, it is mentioned in Kelvin. You can check it by conversion it into Celsius, okay. So these are the major things which you need to consider, which I said, module efficiency and the temperature coefficient of power. Next thing you need to consider is the performance warranty and generation warranty. So basically now it has become industry standard that most of the companies, they give such information, and they give you assurance that their module will give you almost 81 or 80% of output at the end of 25 years. So here you can see that for this particular panel the output can be around 82 or 81% at the end of 25 years, whereas for this panel it is slightly less than 80%, close to 79 or maybe 80%. So these things basically will give you some difference in the annual output as well as over its lifespan. Okay, so this you need to consider. Okay guys, so these were the major points which you need to consider for selection of panels for a particular project. If you have any doubt, okay, then do let me know in the comments or as on LinkedIn or Instagram. The details are on your screen, as well as the links are mentioned in the description. And if you want us to make a video on a topic which you want, then do let us know in the comments. And guys, your feedback is very important for us. So do subscribe to our channel and also comment or like this video, and also let us know what improvements we can make in our upcoming video. So see you guys in the next video.